Hey guys, this is Nidhi. Welcome back to my channel, Nidhi's World. So guys, happy Sankranti to all of you. Thank you very much for watching my videos and subscribing to my channel. So today I'll tell you how we celebrate Sankranti and what are all the preparations we make. So first I'll tell you the preparations. The sugar cane. So this is the black one. There are ones with the green also. So I really like eating the sugar cane. The sakre achu. This is the Brindavan and this is the Mantapa in both colors. So I will show you the recipe on how to make sakre achu in my future videos. So this is the yellow bella. They tell yellow bella tindu valle maatadi. So kids go to everyone's house. Like me, I used to go and give the yellow bella to everyone. So this is how it looks. So guys, in the yellow bella, we have jaggery, roasted gram, peanuts, and then we have the til and dried coconut pieces also. You can see here. You can add the sugar balls or people also add the cumin peppermints. It is optional. You can also exclude them. So next we have the aurekai and the kadlekai. These are the peanuts. So we boil the peanuts in salt water and it tastes really good. You can also boil sweet potatoes, which we call as the genesu. So these are all the preparations. Now I will tell you how we celebrate Sankranti. Before I tell you how we celebrate the Sankranti Habba festival, I will show you the big lemon tree which we have in my native. Just look at how huge these are. Okay, now let's get back to the topic. When the sun enters the Makara Rashi, we call it as Makara Sankranti. When the sun completes the Dakshinayana and enters the Uttarayana, we celebrate Sankranti. It is celebrated all over India because it is the season where the crops come into the farmer's hand. That's why they make the pongal with the newly arrived rice and the jaggery and the milk from the cows. Isn't it so nice? Kajaya. It is also made during the Sankranti time only in Andhra, because usually we make kajaya during the Diwali festival. It is known as Arisalu. So next, the dates of this festival never changes. The other festival changes from months or dates. But this is always 13, 14, 15 or 14, 15, 16. So first, there are three days. The first day is Bogi. When the Bogi is there, we wake up early in the morning, take a nice bath, clean our house and then put colorful rangolis and put a fire from all the waste things which happened last year, which also tells us that we leave the bad and move on to the good. Then they dance around the Bogi Mantalu, which is the fire. They also sing and dance and enjoy. Even the Haridasas come during this festival. So next, in the evening, there are Regi Pallu, which they put on the kids' head and do the aarti. It was also happened to me when I was a little more smaller, like maybe 5 to 6 years. Next, they also call it as Bogi Pallu Poyadam. Next day is Sankranti, which is today. We get up early in the morning, take a head bath and then do the puja to the god. Then we go to the temple and finish the puja there also. Then on Sankranti, on all three of the days, they put big, colorful, beautiful rangolis. And they also put the gobemmas in the middle and dance around it and sing around it. Then on Sankranti, there are a lot of competitions. Not only in the school, they do the competitions for fun also. There are the Rangoli competitions and the kite flying competitions. On the next day on Kanuma, what we do is whoever has oxes or cows, they clean them and decorate them with garlands, and usually people put bells to their horns or their neck and then do the puja to them, thinking of it as the Lakshmi Swarupa. So guys, this is what we do on Sankranti. And this is a very special festival for the farmers. Hey guys, so this Rangoli is colored by me. How do you think it looks? Please comment down below. I hope you guys like my video. If you do, please do like, share and subscribe to my channel. And see you all next time. Goodbye.